For the 9 months, it grew at 7.9% in revenue rupee terms, and with $18 billion of TCV in the last 9 months, growing at 22% year-on-year. What is the kind of growth you see, given the kind of momentum now you have picked up in Q3? Will you be able to cross the 8% revenue growth mark? Because I want to see, which we saw some slowdown in execution in Q2, but now it seems it has come back, and now your momentum is just building up. So will you be able to do that? The second is that you have a 25 to 28% margin, and that's the aim which you said. You hit 25% in Q3, but you have enough levers to end the year about 25%. And the third is about BFSI space. Can you give a little more color on where is the pain over? Because you, Rajesh, spoke about the fact that UK will come back in a quarter or two, but US, what is this, what is what are you hearing from clients there? And I just wanted you to explain the fact that you said budgets are not getting cut, but they're getting optimized. What does it mean?
Yeah. Okay. So we'll again, I'll take the first one, BFSI, and then we'll let Ramki take the margin one. Overall growth, as you said, last year we did 11.5%, 11.4%. We're not going to be anywhere near that. If we do better than 8%, I'll be quite happy, but it is somewhere in that range. There's no taking away from it because the two quarters have been whatever they are. So that's, I think, that's not, the range of possibilities is not very wide there. But we are more optimistic about what comes after that. We'll have to wait and see how this quarter also plays out. But for the structural reasons that I told you, I think that we should be in a better position as we go forward into the next year. But early days yet to start and try to quantify that. BFSI, yeah.
See, as I said, BFSI, significant opportunities. Payments and wealth, I already talked about. People continue to invest in core systems transformation, and then people are looking at opportunities like setting up a completely crypto bank. Those kind of opportunities are coming. Rajesh also mentioned about large growth and transformation programs in retail. Walgreens is a case in point. Likewise, we see opportunities in insurance as well as in banking. The policy administration systems, now the core transformations purely from closed books, we're also seeing opportunities, and we are seeing customers moving open books into a similar model. So overall, from my perspective, as far as BFSI is concerned, there are no pains, only gains.
Yeah, I think you talked about levers, and Rajesh talked about it. In fact, one of the things is definitely where, over the years we have been investing in building the skills, especially around many of the new technologies, and that has reached a very fairly matured level. So there is an opportunity to expand the base. So if you look at it as a pyramid, to expand the base and to do that. So that will definitely have the benefit as we go along in terms of how we drive our costs as well. Apart from that, of course, we will continue to focus on many of the efficiency measures. And in fact, in the current quarter itself, if you look at many of the line items, that is very clearly reflected. Utilization is already at a fairly very high level, but we will continue to focus on that. And lastly, we've always said that growth as well as currency, these are other factors which will. So we continue to stay focused, and we will do that.